conventional estimates provided by both the Pew Foundation and also the Center for Migration Studies suggest that that number is a little over 11 million. And those figures are arrived at via surveys where people are actually questioned as to whether or not they were born outside of the United States and whether they are citizens. What we have done is something quite different. We have not administered surveys, rather we have collected both operational data, such as deportations and visa overstays, and demographic data, such as death rates and emigration rates, and combined these using a demographic model that follows a very simple logic, which is that the population at some point in time is equal to whatever that initial population was, plus everyone who came in, minus everyone who goes out. It's that simple. That's essentially what the model does. We discover that the survey-based result, that there are 11.3 million undocumented immigrants, seems to fall far short. We have a conservative estimate that says the number is at least 16.7 million, and over 1 million different scenarios, accounting for all of the variability in the various parameters that we need for this model. On average, we're estimating something like 22 million undocumented immigrants in the United States.
The main two data sources that we used that other people didn't have access to, one was the number of arrests at the border, because that's one of the ways we calculate inflows. And so the Border Patrol started getting fingerprints from people who were arrested at the border from year 2000, and they started doing it more systematically from 2005. So the data didn't exist that much beforehand. And the other one was the number of people who overstayed their visas, because they also become undocumented after their visa expires. And in 2015 was the first time that such data was actually collected by the Department of Homeland Security. And it's a big, because there's like 50 million people coming in each year. It's hard to track how many people are coming in, leaving, and they didn't have the capability until 2015 to actually measure that number.
We do estimate that the number of undocumented immigrants in the United States is substantially higher than maybe people thought before, maybe as much as twice as high as previous estimates. But it's also important to understand that the increase in numbers happened in the 1990s and the first part of the 2000s. And since about 2008, the numbers have been growing much, much more slowly. It seems like it's a more stabilized system as far as how we're controlling border access and such. So we wouldn't want people to walk away from this research thinking that suddenly there's a large influx happening now. It's really something that happened in the past and maybe was not properly counted or documented. And we're looking at a situation now where there's a large pool of undocumented immigrants in the United States, but most of them clearly would have been here for a while. And we're not seeing that number increasing very dramatically.
One other thing that we observed in this study was that the trajectory of the population. So the population, how it rises, as Jonathan said, it increases in 2008 and then it flattens. It's the same trajectory for our estimate and the ones that existed before. It's just that we're always higher than them. So the trajectory is the same. We see the same patterns happening, but we have a higher number. And it goes back to what Ed said about the undercount of the hidden population. It shows that they are undercounting. They are capturing part of this population, but not the whole population.
This paper is not oriented towards politics or policy. I want to be very clear. This paper is about coming up with a better estimate of an important number. And we're really trying to keep away in this paper from making any statements about how that could or should be used. It's just a paper to help the debate be organized around some better information, which in my opinion is a good thing to do. I think the debate should always be centered around the best information we can develop around numbers. Of course, it's going to get pulled and tugged in many ways, mm-hmm. but our purpose here is to provide better information.
One can imagine people who were very opposed to immigration in the first place making an argument that says, see, the number is twice as large. That shows you that the earlier administration really messed up. They said that they were securing the borders, but they didn't. So we need to be more draconian because twice as many people came in as we thought. One of the most common arguments in favor of a tougher immigration policy is that undocumented immigrants are coming with a lot of criminality. You hear stories about MS-13 and things of this nature. But whatever the crime rates have been in the past up until now, if you ask yourself what was the crime rate among undocumented immigrants, you have the same number of crimes but now spread over twice as many people as was believed before. Which right away means that that crime rate among the undocumented immigrants is essentially half whatever was previously believed.